Last time we have discussed about what is the significance and importance of strategic cost management. So in brief, it facilitates effective cost control, it helps in effective cost reduction, it assists in performance evaluation for purpose of cost control, it helps in formulating pricing policies effectively, then it helps in fixation of sales volume for a desired level of profit. Then it helps useful in prompt ascertainment of cost. Then it optimizes the use of plant facilities and working capital, and is useful for cost estimates and price quotations. Right? Okay. Then what we are basically following strategic cost management, because we want to have a competitive advantage. Correct, right? What do you understand by competitive advantage? Yes, Akshada, Prasad, Rajesh. What do you understand by competitive advantage? You must have
means you should be perform in front. You should be perform in front of competitors. You should be compete them.
Right, and we should have an advantage over competitors. Correct.
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes.
Right. We should have advantage over competitor, so that is called as a competitive advantage. In brief, very correct, Rajesh. So what we are talking about here under competitive advantage, when we are considering strategic cost management, right? One thing is cost leadership, then second thing is about differentiation, right? Then third thing is about focusing, and fourth thing is about strategic positioning, right? I'll just tell you, what do you understand by cost leadership, Rajesh?
Cost reduction.
Leadership, first point, cost leadership. Cost leadership. Okay, in brief, what we understand by this cost leadership, that means a company should have a cost leadership objective under strategic cost management. So it helps us in competitive advantage. Now, what is cost leadership? Cost leadership means a company which is providing products and services, they are producing at such a cost which gives them leadership in that particular market. Correct? Like, suppose, take example, you are producing X product, and when your competitors are able to produce X product of such a quality of, say, rupees 100, correct? But if you are able to produce of the same quality product at, say, cost of 95, then it gives cost leadership, correct? So cost leadership gives you many advantages, right, in competition. Then differentiation. Differentiation means whatever products and services we are giving and whatever cost we are incurring, right? So it is at a differentiation level, right? So it is not at a similar level. So our company's cost structure, performance, and all other things are different than our competitors, and it is in a different, in a such a way which is giving us advantage, right? So that differentiation, every company likes to keep create some differentiation between the company and its competitors, correct? Like when you talk about software companies, when you talk about TCS, when you say about Infosys, Wipro, they have created at a different position for themselves in the competitive advantage, correct? Then focusing, right? So strategic cost management will help us in focusing about we are a more to advantage. Correct? Correct. So this strategic cost management will help the company in positioning itself at a strategically at the competitive advantage. Right? So strategic cost management helps us in competitive advantage through cost leadership, differentiation, focusing, and strategic positioning. Understood, Rajesh?
Yes, sir.
Akshada Prasad. Akshada Prasad.
Sir, in cost leadership means we can say that no one can provide you such products in this range. It
correct.
Is like that, sir?
Very correct. Very correct. Like take example, if you say like products like say Samsung or say Apple products, correct? That iPhone which they are producing, right? Even we feel generally it is highly priced, okay? But the product, what the features it is having, right? And that product, what they're producing at that cost is giving them leadership in that market. Correct? Got it, Rajesh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right? So, what you said is rightly, that is, you're producing a product at such a cost, right? Without sacrificing the quality and all. Correct? It is
yes.
giving you leadership. Correct?
Correct.
Right? So, cost leadership will help you in more of innovative ideas. Right? Various marketing strategies, production strategies, and so on. Correct? Got it, Rajesh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Can I go to next?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then next thing is about value analysis, value engineering, and value addition. Right? So what do we understand by this? Okay. So what is value analysis? Okay. Value analysis is an important technique of cost reduction. Right? There are many other names for this technique, namely value engineering, value control, and product research. So they are interchangeable, but the meaning is almost same, right? So these are basically value engineering and value addition, right? So value analysis is what? It is a systematic analysis and evaluation of the techniques and functions of various spheres of the business with a view of exploring channels and performance improvement that the value in the particular product can be better, right? So what we are saying about value analysis, so value analysis is basically a systematic analysis and evaluation technique, okay? So what you are doing, evaluation you are doing here is evaluation of the techniques, functions of various management of your management, say the functions, right? So our managerial functions of your business, wherever business working, wherever it is affecting, right? So under value analysis. Right, and what you are doing going basically is with a view of exploring channels and performance improvement that the value in a particular product can be better, right? So in value analysis, the design of component and assembly items is reviewed by, you can say, the of the following questions, right? Now how you can review it. Okay, does its use contribute value. Okay, so whenever we are okay, a component or assembly item of a car. Okay, now take example of a component of a car, that means say engine, okay, or say gearbox. Okay, then talk about say assembly items, then when we are talking about the shape of car, correct, and so many other things. I'm just giving you a example of a car under value analysis. So when we are doing value analysis, and when we are when under strategic cost management, when we are talking about designing such a product, right, okay, or the components of the product, or say whatever the items which we are going to assemble when we are finalizing the car. Okay, now what we'll be studying, that does it use a contribute value? That means whatever components which we are using, are they creating any value, right? Then does it need all its features, correct? So when whatever the components, items which we are using there, does it need all its features? Like, take a simple example. If you are putting a music system in the car, okay, do you need all those features there in that music system, okay, in a car? Okay, because what home theater which you are having at home, okay, and the whatever the audio system you are having in the music system you are having in the car, do you think they are same? Or will they have the same features? Yes, Rajesh?
No, sir. For no. Home theater and for car, there is different.
Correct, correct. Basically, when we are traveling in a car, what we are looking for basically in a music system?
Means it should be, say, USB support.
Correct.
You can connect through Bluetooth.
Correct.
And you can play the FM radio.
Correct.
Like this.
Correct. Correct. So whether the range you have is, and whether the frequency can use your CDs there, or whatever the other auxiliaries which you are having. Correct. Now CD is now becoming out of date. Correct. So what you find out here is basically, but at the same time, when the home theater which you are using at home, it will be having different features. It will be having, because it is connected to your TV, right? And you are watching movies and all other things. And then your requirements are different, correct? So under value analysis, we can analyze this, right? Then is there any replacement? Okay, that means, can you replace this product? Okay, or replace this feature by some other thing? Okay, is it possible? That also we will try to search under value analysis. And is there anything better substitute? Correct. So you will try to find out if you want to replace any particular part in a car, correct, whether we are having a proper substitute, right, or you will say is a better substitute, then only you will try to change it, correct. Like, take a simple example. If you have a wiper system, right? If you have, then what is there a bit wiper system? What you are examining? So all this will be done under value analysis, right? Now, when we talk about value analysis, now first we should understand basically what is the term of value here, right? When we are using in value analysis, value engineering, value addition. What do you understand by value? Okay. Can anyone tell me what do you understand by value? Yes.
Only value means the contributions of.
Yeah, very correct, very correct. I'm not asking you definitions, right? What we are understanding in a general term, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Right. What you said is very correct, Rajesh. We can say it's a contribution, right? Whether it is creating any value, right? So we say, whatever I'm going to do this particular activity, is it going to give me any additional contribution, right? Not only in terms of money, okay, but in terms of many other things. Like, take a simple example, like if I'm adding something to my car feature, is it going to increase the customer satisfaction, right? Or the person who is going to drive, whether he will getting a better driving satisfaction, something like that, correct? Like, take a simple example. When you are driving a car, you are using steering, right? And if you nowadays you see the some high-end cars or something, now they are having even the switches there, correct? Which you can use, like increase the volume, decrease the volume, and so many. Some cars are giving these additional facilities, right? And they're charging more to that, but customer is ready to pay for that because it is creating value for him. Correct? So very correct, Rajesh, as you rightly said, it is in simple terms, it is creating some contribution. Then we'll say it's a value. Very true. So the term value is used in a wide sense, and it has different meaning for different persons at different times and places. Correct? So a person will think about value in different terms, correct, at different times and places, right? So even the same person will not value the other things, like other person, correct? So because their understanding, their use, everything is differs, correct? So in order to understand the principles and procedures of value analysis, it is essentially to know which are various types of values, correct? So we'll try to understand what is the value. Okay, the first one is use value. Okay, now what is a use value, right? Now this use value is having certain features, right, which make or useful. Okay, so whenever a particular characteristics or feature of your product is making a product useful, okay, so that it can give useful service for which it is intended. Use value is the measure of the quality of performance of a product, correct? So we say is whenever we are talking about a characteristics feature, right, which is creating some useful value, right? So it basically talks about the quality of performance of a product, right? Now again, whenever we are talking about this use value, again three categories, okay? So first one is primary use value. Okay, now what is a primary use value? It is means that is a core feature characteristics which is creating a value for the customer. Like, take examples. It's an engine of the car, correct? Now whenever we talk about engine of the car, it is a prime use, right? Whenever we go to buy a car, right, you people always talk about what is the engine, how much is the cc, what is the horsepower of the engine, correct? What is the torque of the engine, correct? So what you see is basically it is a primary use, right? We just don't see the car shape, right, size basically at the initial stage, because whatever the size of the car and all, right, it has to be supported by that strong engine, correct, right? So engine, which is a use value. When you say a laptop or say a PC computer, what will be the primary use value? What feature you can say what is very important? Or say your mobile phone, what is very important for you when you go and buy? Yes, anyone?
The it's mobile's look plus its memory.
No, but basically, what you see first thing,
The
what is
look
the
of the mobile,
important
how it's look
in
like.
PC?
How it's look like means whether it is a
Yes, sir.
slim mobile
No,
or
no, 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 no. That is not a use, but that is a say exterior things. But what is the important thing when you go and buy a laptop, PC, mobile? Basically, you're looking for what is the processor, yes or no?
yes sir.
Because processor is the heart of the
Yes,
computer,
yes, yes, sir.
correct? So when you go and buy a laptop, you always ask, what is the processor? What is the capacity of the processor? Whether the processor is fast or slow, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Patches,
Yes, sir.
correct?
Processor will check which
So
processor it
even
is.
in mobile, you will always see for what, correct? Because if the RAM is more, then the mobile will work faster. PC computer will work faster. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right. So that is a primary use value of the product. Like say, engine of the car, engine of a motorcycle, engine of the scooter. So that is a prime use value. Okay. Then secondary use value. Okay. Now what is the secondary use value? Like you say, when we are talking about say scooter. Okay. Now secondary use value of say seat covers, right? Mud guards. These are secondary value. Correct? Because these are additional things which you are putting on the your product, right? Say scooter or a motorcycle. Correct? Or say a car, right? So seat covers, mud guards, right? All these are secondary use value. Correct? And then third one is, you can say, is a auxiliary, right? Value. Okay. Now, auxiliary value is, take example, like if you are talking about a scooter, right? So, like say example, speedometer. Correct? Now, speedometer, which like I say, it's an item for the better performance of the scooter. So whatever the features, characteristics you are adding, right, to a product, right, which will give a better performance, right? So that you will say is an auxiliary value. So basically these three values comes under use value, right? Primary use value, secondary use value, and auxiliary value. Okay. Then second type of value, right? So first one is use value, then second type of value is, you say, is called as esteem value. Now you can understand this esteem value. What will be the esteem value? Yes. Okay, so esteem value is basically what? That it contributes basically making the product attractive, right? And then by selling it to the customer. So that creates an esteem value. So whenever a customer is buying your product and he's talking about a brand, correct? It is creating some value for that, correct? So whenever you're going to buy a smartphone, right? And then which you select, say, Samsung phone. Or which who is a leader in this smartphone in India? Can you name few companies who are leading the smartphone market in India? Like take example, Samsung is there, correct? Then if you want to go for a high-end product, then yes, Rajesh.
Yes, sir. Apple is there, Samsung is there, then Oppo is
But
there.
Apple is a very high-end
High
phone,
end,
correct?
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's very high-end phone, esteem phone, correct? So when you buy an Apple phone, correct, iPhone, it gives you some esteem value, yes or no, Rajesh?
Yes, sir.
Correct. So the project features are like such that it gives you some esteem value, correct? So then even if you talk about smartphones, Samsung is there, then Redmi is there, correct? Oppo is there. There are so many other phones are there. Correct? It gives you esteem value when you buy such a product, because that whatever the features it is having, right, characteristics that product is having, it is creating some value for you, right? When you just talking about Rajesh is about a screen size, right? So the screen size of this Redmi Note 10 or Samsung 12 phone or MC12 phone or something like those models, their screen is very big, correct? So you feel that you can watch some videos, or it is very good to operate and so on, correct? So it creates some esteem value. Certain properties do not give the utility or estimable, which would induce customers to buy, correct? So when we are trying to sell such products like cars or something, like yesterday we were discussing about like say Maruti Suzuki, they are having a different type of distribution network, like Rajesh you were telling about Nexa, correct? So it gives a esteem value to the customer when he goes to buy there some high-end Maruti Suzuki cars, correct? So it makes attractive, correct? Because you as a customer feel it's very prestigious, or you feel esteemed, correct? So the customer is attracted towards such thing, right? Then next type is cost value. Okay, so what is a cost value? It is the total cost required to produce the product. Okay, so it refers to the cost of production to the manufacturer and cost of purchase to the buyer. Okay, so when we talk about cost value, so cost value from two perspectives, one from the buyer, another is from the seller. So both parties should feel that this cost is relevant for, okay, the cost is rational, correct? So when a manufacturer is saying that, he says that this is a cost which I'm producing the product, right? It is at a right that product, okay? And when he's paying the purchase price, that means he will say that is a cost to that party, okay? So he will say even that is a it is creating some value for him. Like take a simple example, like you are a company which is producing say a steering system, correct? And then that steering system you are supplying to a car manufacturer, right? Now whatever the car steering system which you are producing, right, and whatever that the cost which you are selling to the car manufacturer, you are saying that is it is creating some value for me, right? So it is a cost value to you, okay, cost of production. At the same time, when the car manufacturer is buying that steering system for you by paying some price, okay? Now, obviously, when a car manufacturer is buying the steering system, he will not be buying at cost, correct? He will be buying at a selling price, because the when you are manufacturing car steering system for a car, you will obviously add your profit to your cost of production, correct? So, and then you will be selling, but the car manufacturer company will say that when I am buying a steering system from you as a correct, it will be creating a cost value, right? So that is a contribution you are creating. Okay, then next one is exchange value. Okay, now what is the exchange value? Exchange value is what we are talking about, is certain properties of a product. Okay, exchange for something else, right? So the exchange value of a product is equivalent to its you can say it like a sales value. It is an exchange value. When a person is buying something, right, he is giving you money, right, and buying that product or a service, then it is an exchange value. Is it worth? Okay, so that is certain properties which a product is facilitating. Whenever you are buying a scooter, whenever you are buying a, say, washing machine, TV, and you are paying some price, okay, so you say whether it is an exchangeable value, right? Is it having some value? Phone, mobile phone, right, of that 30,000 which I'm paying a cash, okay? So all these are basically the values. So that's why whenever we go for value analysis, value engineering, value addition, we should understand these values and then we should process further, okay? Now improvisation of value, correct? Now whenever we are talking about value analysis, as value analysis we'll talk about mainly it's a use value and to some extent to the esteem value, correct? So whenever we are talking about value analysis, you are talking about mainly two things. It's about use value and some extent is esteem value. Okay, now how you can improve this value? Okay, now value can be improved by three ways. Okay, so one thing is function improved cost constant. Okay, then function improved cost reduced and function constant cost reduced. Okay, now say, like, for example, like when you're talking about function improved cost constant, okay, like say if from one supplier you are getting more rejections, and after looking into the method of production of the supplier, some improvement is made and there were low rejections, so it will improve the function, correct? So you are trying to improve the function of your supplier, correct? So because the rejections have gone down, so that you say the function improved cost constant. Okay, now if you're talking about function improved cost reduced, now we are talking about cost reduced. Okay, so if reverted, and instead of revert combined unit, the cost of reverting is saved, the method will reduce the cost as well as improve the functions, correct? So, and mainly, please remember, these are basically what happens under in technical parts. Okay, so whenever in technical parts, right, when we improve the design and all, right, it helps us in reducing the cost as well as it improves the functions of that particular component. Okay, so that's why we keep on improving the designs. Okay, and then function constant at cost reduce. Okay, like suppose take an example, the rubber seal was manufactured at a cost of rupees 50. Okay, as the cost of raw material increased, that means basically the rubber, okay, it was found that plastic seal also worked well and it will cost you rupees 40. So that will reduce your cost, correct? So a function cost, constant cost reduces, basically it is giving to give you the both means both parts will be giving you same value. Okay, so what you are doing, instead of using rubber seal, as it has, then there is another supplier is there, he says that I will give you a plastic seal, it and it will work as almost same as rubber seal, okay, and it will cost you 40 rupees. So obviously then you will go for 40 rupees because it will reduce your cost, correct? So these are basically how you can improve the value. Okay, now when we are coming to the, say, procedure of value analysis, Okay, so the procedure of value analysis basically, say basically we are talking about is five things. Okay, one is identification and definition of the problem. Then second thing we are talking about collection of information. Then third thing we are talking about exploring and reevaluating alternatives. Then development and planning, and recommendation of the final proposer for implementation. Right? So whenever we are talking about these steps, right? So this will be the basically the procedure of value analysis, right? So whenever we want to go for a value analysis, right, we will first always think about identify the problem, right? It will be necessary to ascertain whether the customer is being given the full use value and esteemed value of for the product he buys, and if not, what does he need, what is required to be accomplished. Correct? So that will come under, say, identification and definition of the problem. Then once your problem is defined, what we do is we will think about collection of information. Correct? So we'll talk about collection of information related to the problem so we can solve it. Correct? So each item of the product or process then is taken up, its function is considered, and all background information and relevant facts like drawing and design, tolerances, material specifications, material labor overhead and other cost, market, competitive products, etc. are obtained before proceeding further with the job and value analysis. Correct? So we will calculate, we will collect the all information related with what problem which we have identified, defined. Okay? Then next stage will be procedure analysis will be exploring and re-evaluating alternatives. Correct? So whatever alternatives which we are having, right? How we can solve this problem by whatever information we are having. So we'll have different alternatives with us, and we will try to re-evaluate those alternatives. Correct? So all potential value alternatives are to be thought of, and the cost of each alternative determined to explore the best method of performing the work at the minimum cost. So we are talking about exploring the best method of performing the work at the least cost. This would involve continuous search for utilization of alternative of substitute materials, components, process, so as to better the performance. Correct? Then next thing what we talk about is development and planning. Right, so that will be the next procedure, fourth stage, right? Development and planning. So the effective value alternatives which we have collected in the previous stage, right, are then tested by experiments and trial runs in order to find out the most satisfactory solution to the problem. So whatever alternatives we have decided, found out, we will analyze them. And then we will try to find out which is the most satisfactory solution to the identified problem. Recommendation of the final proposal for implementation. So that becomes our last stage, right? So some of the questions which would be asked and satisfactorily answered at this and the previous stages are, right? So when we talk about when we give the final recommendation to the top management that we can use this particular solution for this particular problem, right? We need some satisfactory answers. Correct. So we generally use for problem solving. Correct. Now, what are the advantages of, you say, the value analysis? Yes, anyone? Whenever you're going for value analysis, use value, estimate value, all these value analysis, you're trying to identify problems, solving problems, and so many other things, right? What will be the advantages of value analysis? Yes. Yes. Okay. It's very same, right? So, yes, Rajesh.
Yes, sir. While doing value analysis, you can compare the products, means which is beneficial to you, which is not, what quality
very
you are looking for, things like that.
Very, very correct. As well as it will help you in reducing the cost. Correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right? So, how we can list out these advantages, right? So, the first, like what you said is rightly, that is, what is the desired quality of the product, right? How the quality of the product can be maintained. Then it becomes the powerful tool for the cost reduction, right? Then value analysis helps us in making the possible uses of all resources what we have, right? Then by a continuous research for improvement, value analysis creates proper atmosphere for the increased efficiency. Then full use is made of the creative ability and other qualifications of the staff. Right? This creates work intensive atmosphere for the workers. Then as value analysis makes a close study of a product, in order to determine the features which would give the highest satisfaction to the customer, the manufacture of the most suitable product is ensured. Then say, improved and rationalized methods of production and use of latest techniques raise productivity, minimize cost, right? So these are so many advantages of value analysis, right? So, are you clear about this concept, value analysis?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just hold on. I'll drink water and come. Hello. Right. Okay. So value analysis we have covered under different types of values, right? And how it helps us, what is the procedure of value analysis and so on, right? The next one is what we talk about is value engineering, right? Now, as soon as you hear this, read this terminology, value engineering, the word what you get here is engineering, right? So what is this basically then value engineering, which will tell you, right? That means whenever we are engineers, right, engineering is done, okay, that means like designing of the product, right, then all other things when which are related with the technicalities of the product, right, so that will come under value engineering. Value engineering is usually done by design engineer. If you want to just see about what is value engineering basically. So value engineering is an intensive appraisal of all the elements of the design, manufacture, inspection, procurement, installation, and maintenance of product and its components. Right? So whenever we are talking about value engineering, what you are doing here is you are going for a intensive appraisal, right? Intensive evaluation of what? The elements of design, then manufacture, right? Right? That means how the product is going to manufacture, components are going to manufacture, you are going to analyze, right? That come there, inspection, correct, procurement of various types of material parts and so on, right, at your design level, correct, because whenever you are producing a car and that model which you have, for that model you are sourcing the components, right, now your supplier has to produce a product, a component, and you have specified design only, correct, so that is there, installation, correct, and maintenance of a product and its components. Now it includes applicable specification and operational requirements in order to achieve necessary performance, reliability, maintainability of product of a minimum cost. So that is basically what you say is value engineering. So value engineering, which when you are going to do intensive appraisal of various elements, right, why you're going to do that is basically it will help you in achieving the necessary performance, reliability, and maintainability of a product at a minimum cost. So that is value engineering. Okay, now when you talk about value engineering, this basically comes into the technical parts. Okay, because the engineering is more, take example, even if you're say constructing a building, right? Construction a building, right? You have to think about various values whenever you are designing a building, correct? Okay, so all those which can come under say value engineering. Whenever you are designing a car, whenever you are designing a say aeroplane, okay, it's very important to understand. Correct, value engineering, right? The purpose of value engineering is to make certain that every element of what the elements of basically we say is design, supplies, that means components and all, right, and services. Now it contributes proportionately to the function of the product, right? So this is basically the purpose of value engineering, right? Now, when you talk about, say, what will be the elements of value engineering, okay? So what can be the elements of value engineering, okay? Product selection, right? Okay, so the you know that whenever at a R&D level, right, various products are designed, right? And then out of that, you finalize one, which one you will launch, correct? So that is the product selection, right? Then, correct. So you're going to analyze, determine, okay, of those functions. Then, collecting of information concerning the production, such as relating to the present cost, quality, reliability, development history, etc., so that cost can be controlled or say curtailed. Correct. So you are collecting the information regarding production, right? As related with the what is your present cost, what is the quality you're pursuing, right? What is the reliability, right? And what is the development history, right? So the cost can be controlled. So that is another element of value engineering. Then development of alternatives, that will also come under value engineering. Okay, so value engineering will help you in developing various alternatives, technical alternatives, what we are talking about, functional alternatives, right? Then cost analysis of alternatives, whatever the alternatives which you have developed, right? Then what we'll do is cost analysis of that. Okay, then after doing cost analysis of these alternatives, what we'll do under value engineering is testing the alternatives. Correct? Like suppose take example, you want to introduce a scooter, and then for that particular scooter model you are developing say 2-3 engines. Which engine should be put? So there are alternatives for you, right? And then you are going to test these alternatives by putting those engines in that scooter whatever which you have designed, and after fitting that engine in that scooter, how the scooter is performed. Suppose that you have developed two engines, correct? Put those two engines in two different models at a testing level, and you will keep evaluating, right? And then you will find out which engine is good for that scooter, and that engine you will find. Correct, when you will launch the scooter, right? So after testing all this done is, what you will do is you will submit your proposal, right, to the final committee, right? This engine is should be selected, but then again that choice will be assessed, correct? And then the follow-up will be done, correct? So it is basically like this, right? So when we talk about elements of value engineering, talk about perception, analysis and determination of functions, measurement of alternatives, cost analysis of alternatives, testing of alternatives, proposal submission, follow-up, correct? All these things will be done under value engineering. So whenever we are discussing all these elements, basically what you are understanding is this is related with lot of technicalities, correct? Right, so that is basically value engineering. Okay, now if you talk about say the scope of value engineering, where it can be say applied, you can say value engineering. Okay, so you can apply say at a say as a example, we can talk about say at a product stage or end stage. Okay, now when we are talking about a product, okay, now how it can be applied, value engineering can be applied to a product. Okay, so to a new product, okay, that is a value engineering can be applied. Then to the product in development, which you are developing the product, right? So that value engineering can help there. And then to product already in developed. So the products which are already launched in the market, right? Whatever value engineering you are doing, it can be helped there also. So this is the scope of the value engineering in a product. So one thing is going for a totally new product, right? Then second thing is whatever products you are developing, there you can use value engineering. Then third one, whatever products you are already launched, which are in the market, correct? Whatever value engineering you are doing, that can be used in that those products, and it can be improved. Okay, so that is about product. If you're talking about stage level, right, what are the various stages where the value engineering can contribute? The first one is, say, preliminary design. Whenever we are designing a product at a very preliminary level, value engineering can be helpful, right? So it is having a scope there. Okay, then before production, but after preliminary design, right? So once your preliminary design is finalized, okay, then according to that design you go for a production. So before production, whatever this, so value engineering can be helpful in those things, right? Okay, so this is basically about value engineering. Okay, shall we stop here? Almost level of the lecture. Yes, Rajesh.
Hello.
Yes, Rajesh.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Understood this concept, Rajesh?
Value, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Value engine. These are, you know, basically there are very little technical things, right? So whenever we basically discussing about strategic cost management, no, it starts becoming like technical more, because whenever we're talking about cost, it is related with the product manufacturing, correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. So it is little. That's why I'm using little technical terminologies.
Yes, sir.
Right. And another problem here is basically, then it becomes little difficult and tough to explain in this through online lectures. If it is in the class, you know, we can enjoy it more. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then see you tomorrow.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
We'll continue with value addition, and then we'll go to the activity-based costing.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Tomorrow we'll start with activity-based costing. There are various costing techniques, right? Standard costing, like activity-based costing, product life cycle costing, target costing, Kaizen costing, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right. So whatever time we get, we'll try to cover that much as.
Okay, sir.
Okay, because syllabus is of 30 hours.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rajesh. Thank you, Ganesh, Akshada, Asad.